Hi, I am Ravi Venapusa, a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team. In this video, I'll describe how to quickly troubleshoot the most common sign-in issues on Windows 10 and Windows 11 devices with Azure AD. I assume you have already deployed Azure AD Join or Hybrid Azure AD Join, but are facing issues with Windows sign-in. Let's walk through how you can troubleshoot and resolve them. First, let's take a look at the prerequisites you need to evaluate. Since we're talking Windows, you need to have Windows 10 version 18.09 and above, or Windows 11 for desktops. There's no difference between Windows 10 and Windows 11 in terms of device join and sign-in scenarios. If you have a Windows Server, we recommend Windows Server 2016 with the 18.03 update or the latest versions of Windows Server 2019 and 2022. Next, your device must be Azure AD Join or Hybrid Azure AD Join. We will discuss Azure VMs in a separate video, so this is primarily applicable to physical devices. If you have federated authentication, your identity provider must support the WS Trust protocol. Without this protocol, Azure AD sign-in to Windows will not succeed with the federated identity provider. And finally, if you have a firewall or outbound proxy setup, ensure that you're allowing access to Azure AD authentication endpoints from your devices without any restrictions. Before we get into the details, let me first quickly give you an overview of the Azure AD Primary Refresh Token, also called the PRT, as this is important for troubleshooting Windows sign-in issues. A PRT is a device-bound persistent token that enables single sign-on across apps and browsers. A PRT provides proof of device during token requests, and so it's essential to meet the device-based conditional access policies. PRT is first issued during Windows logon for both Azure AD Join and Hybrid Azure AD Join devices. So successfully getting a PRT is equivalent to a successful sign-in to Windows with Azure AD. So what happens if a PRT is not issued during logon? Users usually see one of the following errors. First, and probably the most simple and straightforward issue, is failure to log on to Windows for Azure AD Join devices. Users will see an error directly on the lock screen, unable to log in. For Hybrid Azure AD Join devices or subsequent logon scenarios, users might see one of the following issues. Users may see repeated sign-in prompts from different applications, since single sign-on isn't working as expected, or users will see device-based conditional access errors, since there is no PRT to satisfy the device proof. Now that we know the prerequisites and expected errors, let's look at how to troubleshoot. Step one, check the device record in Azure AD and ensure that the enable column is set to yes, and if you're deploying Hybrid Azure AD Join, the registered column shows an actual date and not pending. For Windows logon to work, the device must not be deleted, disabled, or in pending state for sign-in. Troubleshooting pending devices is covered in depth in a different video, so I'm going to skip that for now. Next, step two, check Azure AD sign-in logs for the application Windows sign-in. This application is specifically used during the Windows logon flow, so it can provide rich information about any failures. In addition, it allows you to investigate issues from the Azure AD portal without a need to look into the user's device. Any issues with user credentials, like password expiry, are surfaced in the sign-in logs. Finally, in step three, if you're not able to identify any issues with the device state or sign-in logs, you can run the command dsregcmd/status on the impacted user's device and check for any issues. If Azure AD PRT says no, it indicates an issue with the device unable to reach Azure AD, or if you're federated, your identity provider to complete the logon. This is a good indication to check network access or the protocol support in your identity provider. In newer versions of Windows 10, starting from version 21H1, we have added additional diagnostics right in dsregcmd to provide you with the errors encountered during logon. This can help you narrow down the issues quickly and resolve them. And that's it. I hope this was useful to learn how to troubleshoot Windows sign-in issues with Azure AD. For more information on our troubleshooting steps and details on how to go about investigating them, please visit the links below. Thanks for watching.